Hey, house guest, it's your girl, rock famous star.
So my voice is like not all the way there. I mean, it like is starting from here, and it's just, I don't know. And yeah, I just feel like I need to like lay down or like just be sick and cry, you know. But whatever. All right, so hopefully this goes away soon. All right, so this is episode 36. The Big Brother. It left off with James and Natalie being on the block. And Nicole was saying she felt guilty for James being on the block. She was like crying in a DR, you know, because she basically turned her back on them. To save her own skin. Natalie, I guess she said that I turned my head right at this moment, but I guess Natalie said that she likes being on the block with James, and I guess Paul overheard and told, you know, Victor and Nicole and Corey Okay, so Natalie goes up and talks with she talks with Victor and Paul, and like when she was doing this, I was just like, wait, what? You know, because right before this, she had been like guilting James, like, you know, we shouldn't have done that. We should, you know, you should have listened to me and should have stuck to my guns. You know, she goes to the HOH room and she's like, you know, she basically throws James under the bus. And she blames him for being on the block. She's like, I put my trust in the wrong people, you know, James. I don't think that she meant to. I think she was trying to take the heat off of her back and be like, I don't know, but I don't think she did it like on purpose. I think she was trying to save her butt, but she didn't realize that she was throwing James under the bus to save her own butt. She was talking about how it may be her last week and that she was sorry. And you know, like when someone's apologizing to you, you just have to like, and you let them talk and keep talking and talking. And that's what they were doing. And then finally they were like, thank you, you know, thanks for coming up, which was, like, a load of BS, and then Paul calls Nicori up to the HOH, and they basically talk about how, like, quick Natalie was to throw James under the bus, and they were saying how, like, well, if you throw your number one under the bus that quickly, then how are we supposed to work with you? Like, we weren't even your number one, so you probably gonna throw us on the bus even quicker. You're going to be driving the bus. So it's starting to, this episode really is painting Natalie to be evicted. Like, it's painting her in a not so pleasant way, which they haven't really done all season. They've shown her as this, like, you know, happy, whatever. But they haven't really shown her as a competitor. So in the veto, everyone's playing because there's only six people left, and it's like, oh my gosh, I cannot believe there's six people. We started out with 16. I remember the first night, like, it always seems crazy, like, that, like, because you're like, oh, there's no way they're gonna evict them, you know, there's no way they're gonna evict this person, like, and, like, 10 people are gone. So everyone's playing in the veto. They're competing one at a time, and I kind of like these competing one at a time competitions. I wish they didn't know, like, the other people's times. I like it when they do that. They have to escape this, like, these rooms with clues, and they have to MacGyver it. That was the theme of the competition. They were talking about the new show. So the players have to escape from three rooms with clues, And Natalie went first, and she had it for a while. Her time was like 9:06. And she had it for like, because Nicole went after her, she failed. Victor went after, he failed. James went after, he failed. So she had it for like quite a while. And then Corey went, and he actually did really good. He like went straight for the polls. Like, I don't know. I was kind of like suspicious of it. Like, he walked, opened the door, and went straight to the poll. Like, it took most people, like, at least a minute or something to figure out that it was the poll. So I was kind of like, somebody, like, you know, on your way up, did Nicole tell you, like, hey, it's the polls, you know, I don't know. Not thinking Nicole cheated, but whatever. So Corey ends up being the winner because Paul goes after him and Paul doesn't get past the second room. So Corey won, and of course he's not going to use it, obviously, because if he uses it on whoever, then that means Nicole would go up because Paul's not going up. That was, like, understood. So Nat told James that she this after competition, I think. I don't know. She told James that she wouldn't talk to him again if he works with Corey and Nicole. And James was kind of like, wow. I wouldn't say that to somebody. Like, that's kind of harsh. And so he was like, you know, I feel like James is a really honest person. And so that really hurt. Like, you know, things get to people's feelings. And so James goes up and talks with Victor, and they tell him what Natalie said to them in the HOH room earlier in the episode. It might have been earlier in the day or the day before. And it made James sad, like, that, wow, like, he wasn't going to go back and tell Natalie because, you know, like, he doesn't need the drama or whatever. But it was just like, wow, this person that I put my trust in kind of, like, didn't have my back, you know. He went out by the hot tub with Natalie, and you can tell he was just so sad, and I felt really bad. He just was this, you know, it might have been for the cameras, but it was just so like, oh man, James. And James, like, I put eviction speech, but I meant veto speech. He says that I would never campaign against Natalie, and I was like, dang, you know, because the other four know, like, what she said. Of course, Corey does not use the veto. I think we all expected this. They're still, like, I guess they're flip-flopping between who will go home. I mean, they're trying to say that Natalie, like, is a competitor now, and she may, like, win things. But I just feel like Natalie, if I was them, Natalie would be the best choice for me to keep because she has nobody. Like, she has, if she wins HOH, say she wins HOH, if I was Paula Victor, I'd be thinking about this. If she wins HOH, there's a good chance she's probably going to, like, she could put us up, she could not put us up, I don't know. But then if one of us wins the veto, we could just take the other one down and the other person go up, blah, blah, blah. But if James stays, James has a more likelier chance of working with Corey and Nicole. I think so. I mean, I think right now, see, I think they want us to think Natalie's going home. But I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. I wish I could talk more, but as you can tell, I sound like a dying little whale. So let me sign off, and thanks for watching. You're welcome. Bye.